The reveal trailer for Hatred is a beautiful postmodern satire of the entire video games industry. Some guy, monologuing through what can only be described as the manifesto of a madman.
I just fucking hate this world and these human worms feasting on its carcass.
Heads out into the street and starts shooting up innocent people, complete with brutal execution cinematics. It was a trailer for a game where you literally play as a serial killer. The black trench coat, grisly voice, and psychotic ramblings painting the perfect picture of the inside of a troubled teenager's maths textbook shortly before they open fire. Eric Harris reportedly said his infamous efforts would be like Doom, a game where you shoot aliens, collect keycards, and can't even look up or down. We live now in an age of eSport Counter-Strike, X-ray moves, and hentai games on Steam. There is an industry-wide movement of progression and acceptance. And then came the trailer for Hatred, which held up a grayscale, ultraviolet mirror to the industry and said, "This is you. This is what you are. This is what you will be. This is Hatred." People went ballistic, obviously. The criticism was universal and frothing. The game was temporarily pulled from Steam Greenlight, Twitch.tv enforced a ban on streaming adults-only games days before its release. The game itself didn't need to exist. The statement was made with the trailer. But that analysis, that praising, that artistry is all in my head. When I reviewed the film Freddy Got Fingered, people told me it was actually a punk rock deconstruction of cinema, that it was intentionally unwatchable. That's all well and good in theory, in retrospect, and from a distance, but Freddy Got Fingered is a real film on a real DVD, and it sucks. Hatred 2 is a real product. It costs £14.99, and like Freddy Got Fingered, it sucks. Although, not nearly as much, to be fair. You play as the antagonist, a man whose name is not important. You run around a series of levels shooting a set number of civilians until the police, SWAT team, or armed forces show up, at which point you shoot a set number of them and head to the next level. Sometimes the goal is simply to reach the end of the stage. There are side objectives to complete, usually taking you to a specific location, like a supermarket, iPhone store, or presidential rally, where you proceed to shoot the place up. Completing these side objectives rewards you with respawn tokens. Die without any tokens left, and you restart the level over again. There are no checkpoints, and if you find yourself out of ammo or stuck in a tight spot, then it's back to the beginning. This gives rise to a slow, joyless playstyle, waiting for your enemies to enter maximum range and taking them out as safely as possible. There's no scoring system, and no incentive to cause any more mayhem than absolutely necessary to clear the level. Body armor is scarce, and the only way to replenish your health is to perform cinematic executions. The only way to guarantee your prey live long enough to perform an execution, however, is to give them a big, flying Duke Nukem kick up the bum. It's an odd maneuver, out of place amongst the dim, film-grained, contemporary environments. The antagonist will occasionally utter a quip after a kill, again like Duke, but while Nukem charmed the gamer with movie quotes and cheesy machismo, the antagonist is completely witless and repeats himself frequently.
Killing time. Try harder.
There's no joy in Hatred. The bleak visual design and basic objectives contribute, but the gunplay seals it. Weapon selection is extremely limited. One pistol, one shotgun, two submachine guns, two assault rifles, three grenades, a jeep-mounted machine gun, and a very rare flamethrower and rocket launcher make up the entire arsenal. You aim, and you shoot. You can crouch, you can run, you can roll. The first 5 minutes of the game is exactly the same as the last five. The enemies just take a few more hits. The game has a pseudo-isometric camera which you can bend about by aiming, but which makes it difficult to see where doorways are and where your shots will go. This is further compounded by the visuals, which obscure enemies, so you'll find yourself constantly holding down the Alt key to highlight them in red, only releasing your finger from the trigger when the light fades. During its busiest moments, things still progress in a mundane, thrill-free manner. Hatred plays itself far too straight to be enjoyable. It might be by design, it might be ironic, but shooting unarmed civilians gets old extremely quickly, and once 5-0 step in, it becomes an incredibly generic twin-stick shooter with sloppy controls and no special gimmicks. The antagonist isn't an unstoppable killing machine, nor is he a cunning guerrilla fighter who sneaks and tricks his way through impossible situations. He just shoots people a lot and then kicks someone and executes them when his health gets too low. Enemies will just stand there and let you finish your deliberate animation as well. Sometimes people run from you, and sometimes they just stand right in your face waiting to die. Passengers on a train will continue to cower in silence as the person in the seat next to them gets violently murdered. Even as a spree-killing simulator, it's not very good. There are very rare flashes of brilliance in Hatred, where you get the tiniest glimpse of something greater than the sum of its parts, a clearer indictment on video games culture, such as the antagonist's comments after shooting up an army base.
One man conquering an army base. Nothing compares to this feeling. Absolutely nothing.
And the end credits, which give special thanks to nobody, fuck you all, except Lord Gaben. But these are so few and far between, they immediately get swallowed up by the monotony of the combat. The game is quite short, taking me around 3 hours to complete on hard difficulty, and the lack of variety and content provide no reason to continue playing afterwards. Hatred does a poor job of realizing its potential. It doesn't make an adequately extensive game out of spree killing, nor does it provide interesting encounters with armed foes. Despite the controversy, the premise, and the striking visual design, Hatred is uninspired and bland.